Hey everybody, it's John. It is Live Fire Monday, sponsored by the Mantis X Performance System, and we're out here at C2 Tactical again. Another real privilege because Neil and Stephanie Widener are here this weekend taking a class with us, right?
Yes.
So two classes. We're taking John Johnson's Tests and Standards and Citizens Defense Research, the Armed Parent and Guardian. So they get to hang out with me, yay! You guys might know, again, Stephanie is our XO, basically the brains behind the outfit at Active Self Protection, and Neil, our director of sales and marketing and sponsorships, and heck, amazing shooters, okay? And we had a private lesson this morning with Scott Jedlinski. He's my coach and your guys' coach too, as we're looking to get better. One of the things that we wanna see is we're working some stuff in dry fire. Today we're gonna verify in live fire what happened. So I'm gonna send you just a little bit of what we were working on, particularly the difference between a defensive fence here and working from a hands at the ready or hands low position, and what that means in terms of our speed. If you're frustrated with your shooting and your shooting performance, you need the Mantis X to help you to get to the next level of skills. It's definitely helped me. So really all you need for this is an objective way to measure your performance. Now, of course, there is a shot timer on Mantis. You could use that if you want today, because we're working from the holster and I don't have a holster that'll work with the Mantis X. So we're just gonna use ye olde Pocket Pro to give us some objective data. Now, here's the straight dope. Neil's faster than I am with a gun. That's just what's up. Straight from the holster to first shot, this dude is the stuff. Have I built him up enough for you? Is there no pressure or nothing, right?
None at all.
Trying to wreck him. You're getting right in his head.
I'm getting right up in his noodle right now. So we've been working on getting that gun out, seeing the first shot, and making it count, right? So we're going to get to the 7-yard line, and we're going to see how that does for us now in live fire. Now, of course, I'm not telling you, I'm certainly no Instagram operator, okay? You're not going to see me pulling blazing .6s or anything like that, but I'm really working hard to get that first shot to get under 1 second on that target. We'll see how close I am today, but let's start with Neil. All right, so the big thing that we've been working on is the difference between a defensive fence out here like this, and then whether you're here at hands at sides or whatever, or, you know, we actually, Scott and I were talking about this idea of sitting here with my hands clasped in front of me. Now, this is a very relaxed position. This could be, for instance, what we were talking about this morning, church security, right? Or I'm just waiting, I'm just hanging out. Now you notice, I'm cheating, man. I have my hem in my hand, right? But guess what? I'm okay for that. Even if I don't have the bottom of the hem, I can have a little bit of pinch grip. That's all I need. It's just a little bit of pinch grip here and be chill. Now when it comes time to go, I'm gonna kind of make sure this hand's letting go. Now here in a defensive fence, I'm doing the same thing. I want you to see how I kind of put my support hand, which for me is my right hand, a little out in front. And that's typical for me. I really do like this kind of, you know, boxer's position, but hands open. Hey man, I don't want any problems, whatever. Then when it's time to go, I come down here and clear, go get the gun, bring the gun out and get my first shot on target. If I'm down here, same thing. I'm gonna get everything kind of settled, get my pinch the way that I want, ready, go, and get the gun out and go to work. Now, how are we going to do that? The key here is efficiency, right? The key here is to eliminate all unnecessary motions. And I'm gonna tell you what, I'm not sure that it'll get 100% on camera, but what Jedi was yelling at me about this morning was the unnecessary motion of finding time here at the belt. Okay, now I've got enough here and I can get the gun out. No, it's bounce the gun out of the holster, get it out, and go to work. So let's see how we do with it this morning. You first, buddy. Okay, Neil, do you understand what you're doing? You're gonna start down there or you're gonna start at a defensive fence?
I'm gonna start right here.
He likes this one. This is his favorite one. All right, so just putting a single shot in the high center, right? In the high center chest. Shooter, are you ready?
Yep.
Stand by.
Ah. See, you got me all nervous.
Let's try it again.
All right.
Deep breath. Relax. Remember, you're finding something in the middle there, right? You're finding something to think about, something that you're not. Right, you're emptying your mind. You're gonna go on the B, right? You understand? You ready? Shooter ready. Stand by. Woo! Now, okay, so we did miss our target a little bit, but 1-2-0. 1-2-0 live fire, and you have not done any of this today live fire.
No.
Dude, I don't know how many guys can do that cold on demand. So again, Instagram operators aside, right? All right, give it a try, another one. Now you're feeling good, you got it out there, right?
Yep.
You know what you're about. Shooter ready. Stand by. 1-4, and we're a little upright. Okay.
I'm not getting my grip.
Okay.
I'm cold.
All right. So go ahead and do one without any timer on it. Make sure your grip is right and you're feeling it strong. There's what you want.
All right. one more fast.
Shoot ready? Stand by. That was a good shot at a 127. At a 127. Now again though, I mean that's in real, no joke, live fire. 127. That's a great shot. One more time. Shoot it ready? Stand by. Woo! Oh, now if he'd had the accuracy, he'd have been in there, but you know, 107, but you missed.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Such is life. Let's see if I do any better. Kinda doubt it, honestly. Now, so I'm gonna give Neil this out here, because one of the things that we're working on right now is we're just working on raw nasty speed, okay? So working on raw nasty speed, one of the things that we have been working on is not over-confirming the dot. But of course, one of the things that I do is I under-confirm the dot when that happens.
That's exactly what I do.
And that's exactly what's going on. Okay, so again, let me just kind of get a feel here. If I'm here, yep, feeling good. All right. Not quite what I wanted, but all right, let's see what we do. See how today goes. Here. On the beat.
Shooter ready?
Ready.
Stand by.
Way low. 116, but way low. Not a good shot. Not a good shot. Let's see if I can do one more. I'm okay with a 116 from the defensive fence. I'm pretty okay with that. Now I just got to not suck.
Right.
See if
Don't
I can get.
Don't suck, John.
Don't suck, John. Grip the gun harder.
Shooter ready?
Ready.
Stand by.
Better shot. 122. All right, so that one, you know, I'm okay with 122. Let's change now to the cheater stance.
Cheater stance.
Cheater stance. Let's see how we do with this. Now this is brand new to me. I just started working on this one today. I don't know how I'm gonna do. Straight truth.
You ready?
Ready.
Stand by.
Woo! 106. I'm pretty okay with that. And that's actually in the 8-inch circle, so I'm feeling pretty good about that. Let's see if I can do this again.
Shooter ready.
Ready.
Stand by.
Ah, way low again.
115.
115. One more time for John. Come on, let me see my freaking sights like I should.
Shooter ready.
Mm-hmm.
Stand by. 105.
But I missed. Let's try it again. Come on, I got to see my sights.
Shooter ready.
Ready.
Stand by.
That was the one I wanted. 123 though. So that's what you see where I am right now. If I'm going to hit my target, I'm in the 115 range or more right now, live fire. So, you know, this is what we do. We verify in live fire what we had in dry fire, and that helps us to get better. Steph, you want to give it a shot?
I'll give it a shot.
Let's do it. So again, we're going to verify our sights. We're going to get our shot, and we're just going to go with what we have, right? You're not, who are you competing with?
Nobody.
Nobody. Just getting what you got, right? And going on the, not the EEP. Stephanie's got a running joke. You might have seen the meme on our Facebook page of one of these with a beaker on him. She made a little craft beaker. So we say that we're a prisoner and the meep sets us free, right? Okay. All right, you ready? You understand? You want to do a draw or two so you feel in a little bit? Go ahead. Very good.
Fast as you two, but
don't have to be, right?
Faster than the target, so I should be all right.
Should be all right. All right, shooter ready?
Yeah.
Stand by.
Okay,
that was a good shot. It was 1-9. Okay, you notice what you did? You sat out there for a long while verifying, right? Let it go. You've got that. Prep that trigger before you get out there.
Okay. Okay.
Shooter ready? Yeah. Stand by. Whole lot better, 166.
Getting there.
You're right there. Okay.
Let me do one more.
One more. Shoot it ready. Stand by. Ooh, how about 139? How about we got under that professional standard? So somebody who's never been a firearms professional
right.
is meeting the professional standard in 3 shots. So this to say, in Mantis live fire, here's what I want you to see on this. You got to come and verify your skills, okay? So dry fire is awesome, and we dry fire, right? We dry fire a lot.
Way more.
Way crazy more, but you gotta come and verify. And I gotta be real, my 115, I was right at 1-0 in dry fire this morning, and so I shouldn't be any slower, but I'm doing crazy things with my head. So come out to the range and get some verification and train, okay? My other bit for you is coaching. We had a great coaching session with Scott Jedlinski with Modern Samurai Project, Jedi, this morning. He's my shooting coach. Appreciate him a lot. Jedi, if I don't say it to you enough, buddy, I really appreciate your coaching. You're making me a lot better shooter, and I think we can all say that.
Everybody
yeah,
agrees.
And he does. I just love that he does those over Skype. Yeah. So we can do it virtually, meet every little bit. He can watch and evaluate so well.
And see what you're doing. He's super,
right.
So super really straight up, too. He's like, why are you doing that?
Stop doing it.
Stop that. God, what are you doing? Hilarious. Jedi didn't ask me to do any of this. This is not paid or anything like that. It's just a friend. Very valuable to train with. So, guys, get out. Use your timer. Get out. See your target. Let's go train.